One, two, three, four. Hi, welcome back. Hey, you know, one of the lessons that you're going to have for just about every chord that we work with in this series is a riff lesson. And in these lessons, I'm going to teach you five riffs that you can use as fills and transitions for whatever chord it is we're working with. Now, you're not going to want to limit yourself to these five riffs. Use these as the basis for stimulating your creative musical juices. Modify them, change them up, do whatever you want to do with them to help you create your own wow factor licks. So let's go ahead and get started. Get your pick, get your guitar, meet me in the studio. I'm going to give you your first riffs in the key of E minor. Okay, let's go ahead and take a look at this first lick. I'll go ahead and play it for you once, and then we'll come back and break it down. Now, you'll see the tab on the screen, and then I want to talk to you about the way you play that with the chords too. But here's how it sounds. This is your first riff. That's what it sounds like. Now, here's what you want to do. When you're playing these riffs, as often as you can, you're going to want to keep strumming the chords while you play the riffs. Now, you can't do it all the time, but as often as you can, you want to practice putting those riffs in while you're playing the chords. That's what creates wow factor. That's why I always say to you, you want to be sure that you're able to do riffs with multiple fingers, right? Well, this is the reason right here, because while you're playing that E minor, you can go ahead and keep strumming that and use these fingers, your middle finger and your ring finger, to play that riff while you're strumming those strings. So it would sound like this. Okay, now it doesn't sound... It's not like some lead guitar player playing, but you're trying to make that sound full as you can when you're playing the, you're the only acoustic guitar player, so you want to make that sound as full as you can. Okay, so there you go on that first one. But make sure that your hand is always doing that nice smooth motion. Now you want to concentrate on hitting the strings where your riff is, but you don't have to play that all those six strings. Just kind of get those middle strings while you're playing it, just enough to get that sound going. Okay, now notice that after I do that riff, I keep that, just keep playing your strum like that. Keep doing the strumming. And again, I'm giving that accent strumming, so I'm raising my fingers off the strings. Now look how different this is if I were to play it like this. Big difference. Okay, so that's your first riff. Now let me show you the second riff. Okay, so your second riff goes like this, and I'll play it for you again. And remember, once you do the riff, you want to try and play it with, once you learn a riff, you want to try and practice playing it while you're strumming that E minor, okay? So this second riff goes like this. Now, if you'll notice, most of those notes that I'm playing are in that E minor right there. And I do that purposely so we can keep playing those, that chord. Okay? So if we were to play that with the chords, it would sound like this. Notice that hand nice and smooth on that strumming, right? Now here's what you want to remember. In these riffs that I'm showing you, we're winding up where you would be playing an E minor. That last note that you play can either, can really would be the note, the bass note of whatever chord you're going to. So for instance, if we were going to an A minor, we would want to hit that open five string, right? Or one of the notes in the A minor. What's important is that last note that you hit has the prominence of the chord that you're changing to. So let me show you, if we were to change to an A minor with that riff, it would sound something like this. Okay, I'll do it again. Nice smooth transition. Sounds so much better than... Whoops. No, we want to do it nice with wow factor. If you were going to a C, you would just end up on that C note right there, the third fret on the fifth. Okay. If you're going to a G, we'd wind up with that third fret on the sixth string, like that. So it'd be like this. So you can work with any chord that we're going to, a D minor. We get that D open. Okay. So that last note that you hit, while in our practice, I'm showing you it goes back to the E minor. But the last note would actually, when you create a riff, it'll go to the next chord. So that's the riff number two. Let me show you riff number three.
One, two, three, four.